My dear students, welcome to today's session. So this presentations or video clips is regarding your first PUC C++ introduction. It is a glance of what you have studied previously, and the same concept applies for your second PUC also. Let us start with the fundamentals of C++. Before starting your fundamentals of C++, first we should know some basic rules in a C++. Let us see which are the rules are here. The basic rules in a C++ are, the first rule is every C++ program uses certain keywords that have special meaning. Example, int, main, void, return. We already know that keywords are predefined words in a C++. The next point is, every C++ program that handles user input and output will contain the line ash include iostream.h. Ash include iostream.h is a header file of C++. iostream.h is input output stream dot header file. Next point, every C++ program is case sensitive. Yes, it is a case sensitive because we already used in a first PUC. You can see the difference here. See, this is a case sensitive, this is a uppercase letters. Next point, every C++ program uses curly brackets to group statements together. Curly brackets are known as a flower bracket. Next point, every C++ program has a semicolon at the end of every instructions almost. Each and every statements will going to be ends with the semicolon in a C++ program, because the semicolon which is not contain any kind of value. Next point, every C++ program uses certain operators that perform specific actions. Example, plus, multiplication, C in, C out. C in, which will accept the input, C out, which will generate the output. Plus, we already know that, which will perform the arithmetic operations. Multiplication also. Like this, we have many operators in the C++ which will perform specific actions or tasks in a C++. Let us see some basic things in a C++. The first one is a character set. What is a character set here? A character set means the valid set of characters that a language can recognize. The characters which we are going to be input that should be recognized by the language. Let us see which are that. That is alphabets, digits, then special characters. In the alphabet, uppercase letters, digits 0 to 9, then special characters, space, comma, question mark, backslash, this all character set in a C++. The next one, tokens. What are the tokens here? The tokens, C++ tokens are the smallest individual units of a program. The smallest individual units of a program is called tokens. So one thing I would like to say here, my dear students, the following are the C++ tokens, but most of the C++ tokens are basically similar to the C tokens also. Let us see which are that. First one is a keyword. Next one is constants, punctuators, operators, and identifiers. Let us explain one by one here. The first one is the keywords. What is the keyword here? Keyword is a predefined word that gives special meaning to the compiler. The programmer is not allowed to change its meaning. Let us see which are that. If, for, else, this, do, float, while, switch. this meaning will not going to be changed in the C++. Why? Because it is a built in the compiler. Next one is a constants. What is a constant here? A constant are identifiers whose value does not change during program execution. The values will not change when the time of the execution. Let us see the types of constants. Before that, the constant is also called as literals. The constants are also called as a literals. Let us see some types of constants or a literals in the C++ program. The first one is integer constant. Second one is floating constant. Let us see the integer constants here. An integer constant is a whole number which can be either positive or negative. That is, example 0 to 9. These numbers, it can be a positive or a negative, any kind. But these numbers are called integer constant. These numbers will not going to be changed when the time of the execution. Let us see the next one, floating constant. Floating point constants are also called as real constants. Also called as the real constants. These value contain decimal point and can contain exponents also. Let us see the example for this. See here, you can observe here 345.89. Here point will going to be represents decimal point. Point will represent decimal point. Next one, character constant. Then last one is string constant. Let us see what is a character constant and a string constant here. The character constants are specified as single character enclosed in pair of single quotes, single quotation marks. Let us see the example for this. For example, see here, the character char, char is a data type, ch is a variable name. See here, p is enclosed with a single character or single apostrophe. This is called character constant. Let us see the string constant. A string constant consists of zero or more characters enclosed by double quotation marks. Let us see the example. If you see the example, you will come to know what is a string constant here. See here, char is a data type, str is a variable name, size of the variables. Here, see, you can see here, the string constant, double apostrophe. C++ program is enclosed with a double apostrophe. This is called as a string constant. I think you are understanding. Right, my dear students. Once again, I am repeating, the C++ programming is enclosed with a double apostrophe. This is called as a string constant. Let us see the next one. Punctuators. What is the punctuators here? Punctuators in C++ have syntactic and semantic meaning to the compiler. Syntactic is nothing but syntax. Syntactic is nothing but syntax and semantic meaning to the compiler. Let us see the example. Some punctuators can be either alone or in combination. Let us see the examples here. The examples are greater than, lesser than, space, plus. See here, you can observe one thing here. Some punctuators can be either alone or any combination. What it means here? Alone means, you can see the example here, A is equal to B. The equal is representing alone. And also these punctuators can be applied in the combination also. A not equal to B. See, this is a combination of a operator. Let us come to the point of next slide. Identifiers. What is the identifiers here? Identifiers are used as the general terminology for naming of variables, functions and arrays. These are user defined names. These identifiers are user defined names. Let us see the rules for the identifiers here. Rules for the identifiers. First rule, they must begin with the letter or a underscore. Always when you're declaring identifiers, you should declare with the letters or in a underscore. Next point, they must consist of only letters, digits or underscore. No other special character is allowed. There is no special characters allowed when you are declaring a identifiers. What is the special characters? The special characters are greater than, lesser than, backslash. These all these things are special characters. While declaring identifiers, we should not use the special characters. Then it should not be a keyword. The keyword should not be declared as identifiers. Just now I told the keywords are for, if, if condition, loop, while. These all these things is a keywords. That keyword should not be used as a identifiers. Why? Because the compiler will not going to be accept that identifiers. Next one, it must not contain white space. You should not give a space between a variable when you're declaring a identifiers. The last one is, it should be up to 31 characters. The identifiers always recognized up to 31 characters. Let us see the next one here. C++ operators. What is the operators here? An operator is a symbol that tells the compiler to perform specific or mathematical or logical manipulations. Let us see the example here. The types of operators. Arithmetic operator. Arithmetic operators are used to performing the basic arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication. Let us see the example. Just now I told you, mathematical or logical manipulations. In the C++ operator, these are the types of operator. These are all the types of operators. So this is the operator. Plus is one operator, subtraction and multiplication. The plus adds the two operands. Assume A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20. A plus B is equal to 30. 10 plus 20 is equal to 30. Like that, the minus also will going to be work. The subtracts also, the multiplication operator also will work in the same manner. Next one, relational operator. What is a relational operator? Relational operator is used to comparing two operands given in expression. The relational operator is used to compare between a two operands. You can see the relational operators: greater than, lesser than, equal to, lesser or equal, greater than or equal. See here, we are relating between the two operands. A is one operand, B is one operand. Equal is a relational operator. And here is also A is greater than B. Greater than is a operator. A is one operand and B is one another operand. We are seeing a relation between the two operands here. These operands, based on the statements, these operands will touch. These relational operators, based on the statement, it will tell us whether given statement is a true or a false. True will represent a 1, false will represent a 0. Let us see the next one here. Logical operator. What is the logical operator here? Logical operators are used to testing more than one condition and make decisions. The logical operators are used to make a decision more than two conditions. When you applying a two conditions, we are going to be use the logical operators. Let us see which are the logical operators here. Logical and, logical or, logical not. These are the operators. These operators also the same way, based on the two conditions. Based on the two conditions, it will decide whether given statement is a true or a false. Based on the two condition, if the two conditions are true, then it will give the output of true. If any one condition is a false, it will give the output of a false. Like that, it will going to be work. Same logical or also, if both the conditions are false, it will give the false. If any one condition are true, then it will give the true only. Then logical not, it will always works in the opposite way. When you input the 1, it will give the 0. If you input the 0, it will give the 1. That means if you input the true, the output is false. If you input the false, it will give the output true. Let us see the next one, unary operators. What is the unary operator here? Unary operators operate on only one operand. Only one operand. Let us see the operators here. Logical not. Logical not, that is the condition, if you give the 1, it will give the output as a 0. If you give the input is a 0, then output is always 1. Then address of. This address of tells where the operand has been stored in the memory. It will represent the address of the variable or a operand in the memory. This is called a address. It will represent the where is the variable has been stored. Then tilde operation too, used for the ones complement. Ones complement is nothing but it's very easy, my dear students. It converts 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. Thank you. Hi.